Welcome to the next video tutorial, Core Java Advanced Object Class Part 12. So, what do we have in this program? So, I'll be creating one class called B. Class B. Here I do have, what do I have here? Int I comma j, and I have one constructor here, int I comma double j. Is if we are passing double, we should declare it separately. So int I double j, int I double j. Now this constructor, it is accepting two arguments. So one is int type, another one is double type, right? So I'm initializing this, this dot I equals to I, and this dot j equals to j. So then I do have a public class here. Public class, the name of the class, it is M11, and in the main method what I'm doing is creating an object for class B1 is equal to new B 10 comma 2.5. B2 is equal to new B 10 comma 2.5. Right. Then I'm creating a reference variable, not the object, for B. B3 is equal to B2, right? So then what I'm doing in the SOP is I'm comparing B1 and B2. Then in the second SOP, what I'm doing is I'm calling equals method on B1 and I'm passing B2 as the argument. Then I have one more SOP here. I'm comparing b1 dot I double equals to b2 dot I. And if it is true, compare the next expression, b1 dot j, whether it is equal to b2 dot j, right? Then what do I have next? System.out.println statement. Here I'm comparing b2 and b3. One more system.out.println statement. Here what I'm doing, I'm calling b2 on here, I'm calling equals method on b2, and I'm passing the b3 as the argument. So then I have system.out.println. Here I'm comparing b2.i whether it is equal to b3.i. It is true. Evaluate the next expression. b2.j double equals to b3.j. What is the output we are gonna get here? So please analyze this program. What is the output we might get? Save this program with the name as M11. Now observe the flow. In class B, I have 3 members. In class B, I have 3 members. Int I, double j, and one constructor that is accepting 2 arguments, and it is initializing current attribute, right? Current object with the supplied value. Current object with the supplied value. This dot I is equal to I, and this dot j is equal to j. In class M11, what it is going on? We are creating an object for class B with the reference variable B1. So here I'm calling the constructor which is accepting 2 arguments, and the first argument it is int and the second argument it is double, right? So whenever we are calling this 2 argument constructor, and we are passing this int and double values, those values will be accepted by this constructor, and constructor will be executing and initializing with the value 10 and 2.5. Now I and j value will be 10 and 2.5 respectively. Next, what I'm doing in line number 17 is I'm creating a reference for class B. Here what I'm doing is I'm supplying B2. Here I'm supplying B2. Now for whichever the object B2 is supplying, for whichever the object B2 is pointing, for whichever the object B2 is pointing, for the same object B3 also will be pointing. For whichever the object B2 is pointing, for the same object B3 also will be pointing, right? So now observe here, we did not overrided the equals method of object class in our class B. So the default implementation of object class equals method, that is to compare 2 references based on their memory address rather than the content. Now double equals operator, basically the behavior of this double equals operator, that is to compare 2 references, that is memory address. So in this case we will get false as the output. Obviously we'll get false as output because both are pointing to the different object, and the object memory address will be different, right? So then it is same for equals method. It is also, we have we know that it is comparing, the default implementation of object class equals method, it is comparing two references based on their memory address rather than the content. So we will get false as the output here, right? So then what about this b1.i? What is the current value of b1.i? It is 10. And whether it is equal to b2.i? What is the current value of b2.i? 10. Yes, we will get true for this expression. We will get true for this expression. b1.i is 10. b2.i is 10, right? b1.i is 10 and b2.i is 10. So what we are doing here, it is attribute by attribute comparison. We are comparing two attributes based on the content, right? So here if I access this I using the b1 reference variable, what is that content that is having I? Inside I we have the value 10, and here also it is same. B2.i also it is having the same content, that is 10. So this expression resulting true, if it is returning true, then only it is evaluating this expression, right? So now what is the current value of b1.j? Yes, it is 2.5. and what is the value of current value of b2.j? Yes, it also remains same, 2.5. so these two attribute values remains same, 2.5 and 2.5, and this whole expression is becoming true. So we are comparing attribute values, attribute by attribute comparison. So this whole result will be true. Yes, we will get true as the output. Then what about b2 is equal to b3, right? B2 and b3 are pointing to the same object, right? B2 and b3 are pointing to the same object. Now double equals operator, it is comparing two references based on the memory address. Now b2 and b3 are pointing to the same object, then we will be having the same object memory address, right? We will be having same memory address. B2 and B3 will be pointing to the same object. Now two references are same. While we comparing the two references, the memory address remains the same, so that is why we will get true as the output. And here what are we getting? Here it is as well, we will get true as the output. Why? Because by default object class equals method, it is implemented to compare two references based on the memory address rather than the content. Now these two, B2 and B3, are pointing to the same object. B2 and B3 are pointing to the same object. So that is why we will get a true, right? Now observe. Here, what is the current value of B2.i? it is 10. B2 dot I, it is 10, right? And B3 dot I, it is also 10. Attribute by attribute comparison, 10 and 10, yes, we will be getting true as the result. B2 and B3 are pointing to the same object, right? And attribute also remains same, right? I will be remains same for both B2 and B3 reference, that is pointing to the same object. Now the content also remains same. B2 dot I content is 10, B3 dot I content is same. This whole expression becoming true. If this whole expression becoming true, then only the compiler evaluating the next expression after the double and operator. Now what is this returning? B2.j, what is the current value of B2.j? It is 2.5, right? Then whether this equal to B3.j, yes, this is also same, 2.5, because B2 and B3 are pointing to the same object, and for this two references object remains same, and attribute as well, right? J attribute as well. So the current value, it is 2.5 and 2.5. So here also for this expression we are getting true as the result. Now what happens? This whole expression becomes true, right? This whole expression becomes true. Save this file and compile and run this. So let me clear the screen by using cls command. Trigger java c command, and here the name of the file, it is m11 java c-d double dot slash classes m11 dot java. Enter. We are getting here successfully m11 file, it is compiled, and the dot class files for m1 dot java file, it is successfully generated in the classes folder. Now trigger java command by using -c -cp option. Inside the classes folder we do have this m11. I'm trying to run this class. So what is the output we are getting? Starting two SOPs are false, remaining all the SOPs are true. Starting two SOPs are false, right? Observe. And the remaining all the SOPs are true. That is what we are getting here, right? So this is it for this video tutorial. I believe that we have learnt something in this video tutorial, and we will analyze next program in the next video. So thank you for watching this video, and thank you for practicing the programs along with the tutorial. Okay, that is very important. So thank you.